students, alumni, faculty, and staff gathered on the campus of Spring Hill College in Mobile today. They're calling for change on how the school handles claims of sexual assault. Earlier this week, we told you about a Spring Hill student who claims the school is trying to sweep her case under the rug. NBC 15's Laura Barcheski was at the event today and joins us now. And Laura, this comes just a day after the college president released a list of immediate actions they're taking.
That's right, Kelly. Just yesterday, Spring Hill College President Joe Lee told me some of the actions they'll be taking on immediately, including putting together two response teams and conducting an audit of residence hall locks. Those attending the Take Back the Night rally today demand more.
Survivors of sexual assault and supporters came together at Spring Hill College in front of the chapel to shine a light on incidents of sexual assault they say are all too common on and off campus.
One in five women will be raped at some point in time in her life. One in three will have some kind of violent incidents happened against her. One in eight boys are sexually assaulted prior to their 18th birthday. So it's extremely important for us to have spaces of healing.
A sexual assault survivor and current student shared her personal story to let others who are struggling know they're not alone. To respect her story and privacy, you will not see her in this video.
I was not able to speak out or to stand up or to protect myself until I felt like I had to protect a friend. And that's not a pat on the back for myself. That is to tell you why these conversations are important.
The student says this is only the beginning and they will continue to fight for change at Spring Hill College.
Spring Hill has made mistakes, but again, with our passion, so many of us still care and love for this school. So I fight for better. I demand better. It's not enough to dismiss. It's not enough to write off Spring Hill. We will force them to continue and make up for their long past mistakes.
Lifeline's Counseling Services Executive Director Chandra Brown says she hopes the college is on the right track to repairing the damage that's been done and making it a safe space for everyone.
I hope that the students who have come forward, the very courageous students who have come forward and alumni have helped the campus get an opportunity to see that the damage that sexual assault can cause and that causes victims to carry throughout their life.
If you or someone you know needs help, you can call the National Sexual Assault Hotline at 1-800-656-4673. You can find more resources if you click on this story on our website, mynbc15.com. Kelly?